Hi, today I'm going to make clerodendron, a very pretty and beautiful flower, which will look lovely as a gift.
Material required are crepe papers in red, white and green, green colored acrylic paint, green tape, floral tape, a thick wire for the stem and thin wire, and some cotton wool.
The stencils are given at the end of video. Now take a thin wire and measure out about 7.5 centimeters on the scale and cut that piece out. Take the green tape and cut out a small piece from it. Cut this in half. Stretch it and wind this on the wire that we've cut. Now take the white cutouts, the sepal shape. Take one, fold it in half, hold it like this, and then just pull the edge and open it out like this. So I've already done that. Now apply glue on the base and stick a second one on it at an angle like this, and stick the third one again in the similar way on it. So I'm going to stick the rest, the other two also, forming a fan shape. So this is how it will look. Now apply glue on the back. The bent side should be on the back side, so just apply glue and then put the wire that we prepared in the center and stick the sepals over like this. And while holding it, just open out the sepals and put them in position. This is how it will look. Now take the other piece of tape after being cut and wind this at the base, just a little bit, just covering the base of the sepal like this, and this much only. You can just tear it off. This is what you will get. So this is the open sepal. Now I'm going to make the flower. Now take the petals, the red colored petals, and first take a pair of scissors and curl them. Then again, as we did for the sepals, apply glue on the base and stick all of them in a shape of a fan, overlapping the stem and at an angle like this. Apply glue again. Take the white paper and cut off about 1/2 centimeter wide strip from the edge. Like this. Now measure out about 4.5 centimeter on the scale of the strip and cut this piece out. Then apply glue on it. And just twist the strip. So you get a piece like this. This will be the stamen of the flower. Now take the green color and take the stamen that we've made. Just color the tip just a little bit to form the stamen top. This is how it will look. So make four of these like this. Now take all the four stamens, collect them together, hold them at the same height. Apply glue on the base. Now I have prepared another 7.5 centimeter long wire, covered it with tape, and just put this in the center of the stamen and roll the stamen so they stick on the wire. Like this. If they don't stick, you can always cover this with the tape just to sort of make sure that don't fall off. My fingers are very sticky, so this is how it will look. Now take the petals, apply glue on the base and stick this around the sepals that we made, the stamen, sorry. Just like strip it and overlap the other side. And while you're holding the base, just open out the flower. Like this. Take the red paper and cut out a small strip from it against the grains. Stretch it, apply glue on it. And wrap this from the base of the flower till about 2 centimeters. This is how it will look. Now take the sepals, and the bent point of the sepal should be inwards, so apply glue on that side. And stick this on the flower. The points of the sepals should be at the base of the, touching the base of the flower. And just wrap it around. Just position the sepals if you wish. And this is how the flower would look. Now take a small piece of green tape, cut in half again, and then just wrap it at the base of the sepals as we did earlier. For the closed buds, take a sepal piece and fold it in half. Press the crease tightly. Then apply glue on the side, one side, and stick another one. I've already pressed these, so just stick the other one on it like this so that the edges stick. Then stick another one in the same way. So you have to stick all the five like this. They all have to be folded and you have to stick them one by one on each other. And this is how it will look. So now just apply glue on the last flap on one side and the base. And stick this on this wire, again 7.5 cm, and covered with tape. You can always use florist wire if you have, and then just stick the first the flaps so it closes, and holding this, just twist the stem, the base of the sepals on the wire. And this is how it will look. Just open out the flaps in all directions so you have a closed bud like this. Now, as we did earlier, cover the base of the sepal with half of a green tape. Just a little bit, and this is how the closed bud would look. Now take the square piece for the bud, the red color. First stretch it like this. I have already covered again a 7.5 cm long wire with tape, so apply glue on it and take some small piece of cotton wool and put it on top. Make it like an earbud. Then take the square piece, apply glue on it. And stick this on top of the cotton wool. Just press down the sides. And twist the base so you have a bud like this. Now I've already made, just like the closed bud we made earlier, so I've already stuck the sepals in the same way. So apply glue on the edge of the flap as we did earlier, and on the base. Take the bud and put this just above the point of the sepals and stick the flap over. And twist the base. This is how it will look. Now again, with a little piece of green tape, just cover the base of the sepal. Now take the green tape, take a long piece, cut it off, cut it in half as we did earlier, stretch it. Now first I'm going to join these pieces that we made. So first I'll put the closed bud and a semi-open bud. Put them together like this and wind some tape at the base. Make bunches like this. You can add more of these if you want. So you have a bunch like this. And then I'm going to take the open flower and the sepals and make a bunch of this. So just wrap some tape and make bunches like this. I made another one. Now I'm going to assemble the whole lot. So take a thin wire about 16 to 17 inches long. First, hold the closed buds on top of the thin wire and start wrapping the tape on it. And after about half a centimeter to 1 centimeter, take another bunch and attach that. So you can attach about 8 to 20 flowers or open sepals or buds like this. Attach another one like this. And this is how it will look. Now just open out the flowers and the sepals, the buds. Just position them up a bit. And this is how a bunch would look. I have made others like this. Now I'm going to make the leaves. So take the leaf. First, keep a thin wire on it, just to sort of measure. And from the base of the leaf, measure about 1.5 centimeter for the petiole, for the stem. And then leave another 1.5 centimeter. So just cut out this much of the thin wire and wrap this with the green tape. Just put the tape on top. Now take the leaf. First, stretch the edge of the leaf by holding it between your finger and thumb and pulling the paper. Like this. Then take a pair of scissors and score lines for veins. On the leaf. This is how it looks. And then just stretch the paper in between each vein. So stretch it up like this and then downwards. So you get these indentations on the leaf. Apply glue in the center of the leaf. And stick the wire that we prepared on it. And this is how your leaf would look. I made the others like this in the same way of different sizes. Like this. Now take the green tape and pull out a long piece from it. Take the thick wire, stretch the tape and take the two smallest leaves, hold them on top of the thick wire facing each other like this and wrap the tape over. Then covering about 2 centimeters, take the flower bunch that we made. And then wrap the tape over once. Then take the next leaf. The leaves are always just below the stem of the flower. So just hold the leaf together the same height and then just wrap the tape over like this. Then go down about 6 centimeters from the base of the leaf and you can attach another bunch. So I'm going to attach 2 now. I'll have one like this, and this one I've made which just has open sepals, sort of shows that all the flowers have dropped off. Make one circle and then attach another set of leaf. So you go on like this. Another 6 centimeters down. Now I've already made a bunch of flowers and attached it on thick wire like this. So this is like another branch. I'm just gonna stick this. Just bend the wire and attach it here. And then attach some. A pair of leaves again. The leaves are always opposite to each other. And then you can attach bigger leaves in the same way. This is how it will look. Now just open out the leaves. Make them almost horizontal and curve them up a bit. This is the brand that I put, so we can curve this also. The leaves are always opposite to each other, and this is how the stem would look. Now I've made another branch with just leaves on it. Since I'm making a potted plant, so I need a lot of these leaves also and this also. And this is how it will look. I have put in all the stems in the vase, and this is perfect for a little gift to anybody. All the measurements are in centimeter. This is a stencil of a sepal, 1.5 centimeter wide by 3 centimeter, and the stem is 1 by half a centimeter. Cut in white gray paper, 5 pieces per bud and 5 pieces per flower. This is for the stamen. This is 4.5 centimeter by half a centimeter wide. Cut 4 pieces per flower. This is of the petal, 1.25 centimeter by 2.5 centimeter, and the stem is 1 centimeter by half a centimeter. Cut 5 pieces per flower. This will be in red. And this is for the bud. This is 2.5 centimeter wide by 3 centimeter. When we have leaves, you can cut as many leaves as you like. These are of different sizes, so this is the smallest size approximately. So this is 3 cm by 2 cm. The next size I've taken is 6 cm by 7.5 cm. Then 7 cm by 9 cm. And the largest I've taken is 8.5 cm by 11.5 cm.